Welcome, dear students. We are moving to the third chapter in business studies, that is private, public and global enterprises. Private, public and global enterprises. So, in the second chapter, we learned more about what are the different forms of business organization. And in this chapter, you are going to learn more about what are the different organizations like departmental undertakings, statutory corporations, government company, global enterprises, and joint ventures. So, we will learn in detail all these concepts. Before that, we have to know more about what is the condition up to the 1991 new industrial policy in India. Actually, after the freedom fight, when India got independence, Indian government given some restrictions to the private sector in India. Up to that time, lot of foreigners came here and conducted their trade activities, industrial activities, everything. So, after a great experience, Indian government changed their criteria. They put several restrictions in the private sector business enterprises. India government given lot of opportunity for upliftment of public enterprises, public sector enterprises in India. When the 1991 industrial policy came, lot of restrictions have been removed. So, after that, public sector given less importance and private sector got emerged more importance. That is why the privatization, liberalization and globalization concepts came into existence. Today, in this lesson, first we are going to learn about what is public sector enterprises and what are the different types of public sector enterprises and what are the benefits of these type of public sector enterprises in India. So, let us discuss about what is public sector. From the term, it is very clear, public sector. The whole authority vested in the hands of public to manage these type of organizations. So, public sector enterprises are those enterprises which are owned and controlled by the central or state government, and the public sector is the part of economy composed of both the public services and public enterprises. Public sector involves providing service to the public and also productive activities in the public. It includes public goods and governmental services such as military, law enforcement, infrastructure, public transport, public education. Lots of different sectors are there coming under public sector. So remember, the enterprises which are owned and controlled by central and state government is known as public sector. And we have to learn more about what are the different objectives of public sector enterprises. So, first one is to bring about speedy industrial development. So, every time public sector enterprises given importance for the fast change in the industrial area. So, development of industrial sector is the first criteria as per public sector enterprises. And the second one is to develop certain industries which help the growth of other industries. Some industries will work with the support of core industries. And in rural areas, lot of industries have been started for the welfare of the society and welfare of the development of this country also. Third one is to set right the regional imbalance in the growth of India. growth of industries. So there will be some imbalance. We have to reduce that in order to bring a change in that. Public sector enterprises given more importance for the growth of industries, and also to check the growth of monopoly. Monopoly means one person or one organization, one industry controlling the whole system. So to the public sector and the concept of public sector gives more importance for eradicating these type of negative aspects and to bring easy access of all these type of industries for all. And last one is to ensure adequate supply of essential articles at fair and reasonable prices. Mainly, public sector enterprises given importance for the service of the public sector by providing essential articles, means products, at fair and reasonable prices. So these are the objectives for bringing public sector enterprises in India. They are given more importance. Then, what are the different features of public sector enterprises? As the explanation indicate, first one is state ownership. That means the ownership of the public sector enterprises is vested in the hands of government, maybe central or state. And who is controlling it? Not only the ownership, controlling is also done by the central and state governments, the concerned government as per the locality. And what about the state financing? Government gives maximum capital and fund for the working of the organization. Remember the points: ownership and control by the central and state government, financing also by the government, then socio-economic activities. Main objective of this type of organization is providing maximum societal benefits, providing maximum benefits or supports for the welfare of the society. Public accountability, and these type of organizations are more public accountable. They are providing maximum services and products for the welfare of the public. So some more features are there. We will learn the next class what are the different forms of public sector enterprises. So remember the different features. It is a summarized form. Ownership and control is vested in central and state government, and financing is given by the central or state government. Also, economic activities, socio-economic activities are the main activities. Means all the activities are for the welfare of the society, economic upliftment of the society, increasing their standard of living, etc. And the public accountability, all these organizations are accountable for the public, means they done all the activities for the welfare of the public, not for earning profit like private organization. And what are the different forms of public organization or public sector enterprises? Three forms are there: departmental undertakings, public corporations, government companies. All these three type of organizations are under the control and ownership of the central and state government. We will learn more about all these three concepts in the next video lesson. So develop the concept, what is public sector enterprises, what are the benefits of it, what are the different features, and what are the different types, from again watching this video. So we are going to learn more about the different types of public sector enterprises in the next video lesson. So thank you for watching. So develop your own concept by developing and collecting more examples from the different platforms. So thank you for watching. So keep in reading all these materials again and again. Watch the video again. Okay. So remember.